Hangar flying, I think that's what I wrote down. I can't read my own writing. He asked about why he has less men on low quality. I'm not sure why, but I believe there is an option where you change the amount of men that are shown on screen. I believe there's that option in your graphical settings. I'm not entirely sure, although I remember I talked to a friend about it. So there is an option to change how many units you're displaying, and that's why, because you put it to lowest settings, it changes that option to lowest, and that's why you only have 40 out of 220 troops, or sorry, out of 120 troops. And also moving on, Portable Retard wants to know how I get my keyboard to type in Russian. It's a program I downloaded, but it's not like Russians have, you know, their own standard keyboard. And the program I downloaded, it's not that keyboard, the same layout as they would have in Russia. It's all phonetic, so the Russian, the Russian S, the word S, is still S on my keyboard. So even though in traditional, in on a Russian keyboard, it would be in a different place, but for me, it's all phonetic. So I typing in Russian is almost typing like typing in English for me, because I can still make all the sounds I need are mapped to the same sounding key on the keyboard. But it's a program I downloaded. I can't remember the name of it exactly, but if you really want to know, I can look it up for you again. Moving along, Syncom7 wants to know which person I would meet in history and why, and his rule is it can't be Joseph Stalin. So, I thought a lot about this, and I think if I were to go for, like, at first my first instinct was to meet Hugh Laurier, who plays House, because I love that show, and if there was a man alive that I wanted to shake their hand, it would be him. But in terms of like actual like historical figures, I kind of narrowed it down to I'd like to meet Fidel Castro, because I think Fidel Castro is the man. And or I'd like to talk to Karl Marx, because I would want to talk to him about his theory of communism and kind of get it straight from the horse's mouth, so to speak. And so probably one of those two guys would be the kind of person I'd want to meet in history. And moving along, I like this. A Magodog 122 says, "Hey man, can you add me as a friend?" And I think this is funny, because he went to the effort of sending me a message asking me to add him as a friend, where he could just have clicked on my profile and clicked add as friend, and I would have accepted that. And I don't understand, because it takes far more effort to write a message and then ask me to add him, and I probably won't do it, because because that's lazy, or I'm lazy. And I accept anyone who adds me as a friend, so I just don't understand why he wouldn't have just clicked at his friend instead of actually sending me a message. I don't know, it's just really weird. I got a lot of questions about the Turkish tunnel we're building right now. And one guy, I can't remember his name, he asked me if the attack on Sweden failed, wouldn't the Swedes just use the tunnel to go to Istanbul? And one, I mean, the attack's not gonna fail, man. Come on. Like, if you saw thousands of Turks just rise up from the sand, you'd be scared shitless. You would, you probably just lay down your guns and roll over right there. But say they actually did lose our invasion of Sweden. Say they actually did lose. You really think you could beat the expert tunnelers in their own tunnel? I mean, if they're trying to go through the tunnel, Turks are not only masters at building tunnels, they're masters at combat in the tunnel. So they would probably be able to destroy the Swedes with the various guerrilla fighters that they've placed before they even got to Istanbul. So, of course, there's no way they could actually use the tunnel to their advantage. I mean, you're in the Turks' court, right? There, you can't win that battle. It's just foolish to even try. But I had some other stuff I wanted to talk about. I don't have it written down here. Hold on a sec. Oh yeah, I had something I wanted to talk about. Bobsleigh12, he commented on my video, and he has this weird thing. He likes to tell people what to do, and it's kind of irritating. And I remember he commented on my top 10 games of all time, and he said something like, your taste in games are terrible, or some shit like that. And you know what, man, go fuck yourself. And also he commented on my on my Battle of Vienna, and he says, I don't like the way, it was on my profile, and he says, I don't like the way you took Vienna. You should have charged all through the breach. And one, that is the stupidest idea of all time, because if I had focused all my troops into one small section, it would have been a freaking bloodbath, considering that the Austrians had far superior melee abilities to me, because in hard mode, the units do have far better, they get a boost in their melee combat. So it would have been just a stupid idea to focus all my troops into one select killing zone. It would have I probably wouldn't have won that battle if I had done something like that. So stop posting ridiculous things on my videos. Thank you. But I think I'm done for now. I don't think I have anything more to complain about. So, that being said, this has been Joseph Yusuf Ronovitz-Stalin, signing off for now, and I'll see you guys next time.